Hello, hello, hello. Oh, it's working now, huh? You couldn't have worked. Why couldn't you have worked? I just want to use my. Where's my. Why can't I use my mic? I want to use my other mic. It's fine, I suppose. It is perfectly fine. Just want to make sure it works because I just totally redid this all over again. And I have to do it again because it didn't go through on my mic that I wanted it to. So, this is the third time I'm doing this. I'm sorry. How are y'all doing today? I hope you're having a great day. It's a Monday. Happy Monday. And I hope you're having a good Monday so far. And I hope it's the start of a great week for you. Reading this devotional for a third time. I'm having a great day. And yeah, you can see that my lips are not matching my talking is not matching my lips on the screen, and that's because I forgot to unmute my mic for this video. And so you're just gonna see me talking and stuff throughout this whole video, and you're not gonna hear anything. This is gonna be like 4 or 5 minutes long. In the last 20 seconds of the video, you can see me realize that I have muted the whole time, and without and not realizing it. So there's that. But yes, we are on day 116 of the daily devotional. The devotional book I'm reading this from is called Everything I Know I Learned from Sports. It's a 1 year devotional written by Josh Cohen. Details are down below in the description, so make sure you go check that out. The verse for today is Romans 116. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God and salvation for everyone who believes, for the Jew first and also for the Greek. And the name of today's devotional is Unashamed. If you haven't realized by now, I grew up in Minnesota, but I have relatives in Chicago, and our family vacation every year was making the drive down to stay with my cousins for a few days. It was great. The only problem was that almost the entire drive is through the state of Wisconsin, which means there were Packers fans everywhere. To me, that meant I had to wear my Vikings jersey during that drive so everyone would know where my allegiance was. If you watched How I Met Your Mother, you've seen Marshall do this. They didn't make that up. We actually do this. The Twin Cities of Minneapolis and St. Paul are really close to Wisconsin, so Minnesotans may cross the border fairly often, especially since you can buy better fireworks over there. And every time you enter Wisconsin, you wear purple. That's the rule. It's easy to be a proud fan of your team when you are in your home state surrounded by other fans. It takes a little more to be unashamed in enemy territory, but it also means a whole lot more. It's pretty easy to raise your hands and sing worship songs when you are in church surrounded by other Christians. The real question is, do you live unashamed outside of Sunday morning service? I'm not even talking about evangelizing, although that's a good thing. You should openly talk about God and share your faith with those around you. But you should also be representing God so loudly with your lifestyle that there's no question what you believe. You should be different from the world. You shouldn't be doing anything or doing everything they are doing or saying everything they are saying. Your classmates and co-workers should know you're a Christian without saying a word. And if you go back and watch my testimony video, if you haven't, I strongly suggest you do that. But one thing I'm trying to do is just live for God. Show I'm not ashamed. I'm doing a YouTube channel, playing video games and talking about God. How many people do you see doing that? And I'm not really big or anything, but it's still, how many people do you see doing that? And not many. There are some, but not many. And I'm just trying to be different. And I try to be different through example and just live my life for God. And I don't want to be ashamed of my faith, and I'm not. And whenever I'm in situations with friends that aren't saved, I want to display to them the glory of God and show them why they need to be, or not to be like me, but have what I have that they don't have, and that is God. And I just want to spread the word of God and expand his kingdom by leading through example and spreading his faith, his word. Through YouTube or some other sort of ministry. And that is my goal, is to honor and glorify God in everything I do. And I hope you have the same goal as well. And I mean, that should be your overall goal in life. And that's your purpose on this earth, is to glorify God. And so, might as well fulfill your purpose. It's a great feeling to fulfill your actual God-given purpose on this on Earth. And But anyways, have fun watching. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video. I hope you watch it. It's a bit aggravating because I take over all of China and I leave Japan there at the end. I can't take Japan yet. I'm not strong enough just because they're pretty heavily defended with their forts and whatnot. And I'm going to have to bomb them a lot. But you see that at the end of the video. And also in the last 20 seconds, I realized my mic is muted the whole time. So enjoy watching me look like a dummy. And yeah, I hope y'all have a great rest of your day, and hope you have a great week. And this is all for His glory. Push.
Zum Ausrücken. Thank you.
Captain. All right. Zuhören. Thank you.
Schuss.
Bereit zum Ausrücken.
Befehle.
Thank you.
Abstand halten. Befehle. Bereit zum Ausrücken. Bereit zum Ausrücken. Ihre Befehle? Zuhören. Zuhören. Zum Ihre Befehle. Angetreten. Ausrücken. Bereit. Ausrücken. Angetreten. Zuhören. Ausrücken! Ihre Befehle? Achtung! Zuhören! Zuhören! zurücken. Bereit zum Ausrücken. Angetreten. Achtung. Bereit zum Ausrücken. Befehle! Bereit zum Ausrücken. Angetreten. Zuhören! Befehle. Bereit zum Ausrücken. Angetreten. Achtung. Befehle. Zum Ausrücken. Bereit. Befehle. Unter Beschuss. Ihre Befehle?
Has my mic been muted this whole entire time? I don't know. I might have muted my mic this entire time. It's an epic fail. Anyways, I hope you all have a great week. This is awkward. This is for his glory. Peace.